They weren't even able to penetrate talk about your relationship, your husband and wife relationship, and penetrate your unity.
Amen.
Well, you shouldn't like him today, or you shouldn't like her today. Child, if I were you, this is what I'd do. Well, you ain't got no opinion on this.
Amen.
I mean busybodies. I don't mean people that mean well. Trying to help the FBI. We all need help. I know I do. How about you? Sometimes I need him. But sometimes we get out of order. And we need somebody to bring us back in line. And so it was by faith that he gave his son as a sacrifice. Romans 12, chapter the first verse. We're going back to Romans. This is Soul Camp 101, part 3. How do I bring my soul into receiving what God has for me so that I can be changed? Say with me, if
my soul ain't
changed,
my lifestyle won't change.
See, your soul is comprised of your mind, your will, your emotions, your intellect. And so we don't dissect this thing line upon line, precept upon precept where you can get it. Romans 12, I'm going to read those three verses that we're bouncing off of at the moment. This is Paul talking to the church at Rome. And so then, brothers and sisters, I plead with you. Meaning, I beg you to give your bodies to God because of all he has done for you. Let them be a living and holy sacrifice, the kind that God will find acceptable. So he's pleading. Give your bodies, give your whole self to God. This is truly the way to worship. Verse 2. There's a lot of meaning in this one right here. Don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Then, and only then, you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good, pleasing, and perfect. Say with me, I want God's good, pleasing, and perfect will. Man, if you got God's pleasing, good, and perfect will, all is always well. Even when things look like hell is breaking all things loose, it's well. Hell can't even go penetrate well, it's well. I don't care what's going on, it's well. Because I'm in God's good and pleasing and perfect will. You got to let that settle. Let that settle in good news when you're having fun. Let it settle in bad news. Let it settle during your testing time. Let it settle. It is well with my soul. And so we understand now that we don't belong to ourselves from part 1 and 2. We were bought with a high price, we said, which is the blood of Jesus. God purchased us with his son's blood for his own use. Say with me, I'm for God's use alone. And so we have to refuse to join ourselves to anything that does not please God. Let that sit in your soul. I got to refuse to join myself. You know why? Because we turn into a whole different person when we're outside of the four walls. It's like we just blend right into whatever it is. This is who I am now. But we got to let God's pleasing, good, and perfect will stick like glue to our soul. And we got to tell ourselves, I am only to do what is good and perfect to God's use alone. Living a lifestyle of sin does not please God. But being connected and joined to the Lord in the Spirit, we saw that, makes our bodies become alive to God's word. You saw that? We don't join ourselves to the world like 1 Corinthians say, to a harlot, to a prostitute. But we join, we become one with God, glory to God. So that our bodies can become alive to work for Christ. So if you're connected to sin, your body's going to obey it. body going to do. So we therefore move from being a dead man walking to a living and holy sacrifice. The word sacrifice, we said, meaning to give up something. You don't give up yourself to nobody but God. I don't care how cute they is, I don't care how handsome they is, I don't care how much money they is. Sacrifice a little bit for them. Mm-mm. What belongs to God belongs to God. And you can't take God's stuff and connect it to sin. You got to let that sit. Because you're going to clearly see in scripture that if you do that, you're going to find out who's your daddy. You're going to find out who your real daddy is. But say with me, I can do this. I'm empowered by God. See, you got to know the truth, and the truth will make you free, and you got to hold to it. I hate phony people. People live all kind of lifestyles. You got people that live like a man by the day, and at night they live like a woman. It's like, that spirit of deception and hypocrisy is on the rise, and it's walking about seeking who it can take out. You got to know who you is, who you are. Excuse my French. Sacrifice means to surrender for use to another. It means that we are set apart for God's use. You are consecrated. Consecrated means this cup is consecrated, meaning it's set apart for water and drinking. How you gonna use the cup to try to suck food through it? I mean, I'm gonna put me some lima beans and rice and egg on and just. You ain't getting nothing out of that straw. The cup might hold it for sure. But this cup was only set aside, set apart for drinking liquid. Now, if you gonna put it through a blender with a little water in it, you can eat. But we gotta understand the meaning of definition. Words have meaning, and they carry great significance. Yes. You can't avoid that. You can't be so caught up.
You know, I know that's what it means, but I'm just caught up right now.
You gotta understand what words mean. So we're sanctified. We're sanctified and made right with God through the shedding blood of Jesus Christ alone. It's not of what we've done, but it's what he done. All we need to do is receive it and let the power of that thing do what it do in us. So this word is very important. You can't get clean unless you're clean through the word, the Bible says. It's the cleansing agent. You say the word I speak, they are spirit and they are life. The washing of the word. It is the washing of the word for the soul that calls your soul to be cleansed. The word is a cleansing agent. It cleanses doubt. It cleanses and roots out sin and bitterness and all these infections that we have in the sensing soul. When the soul is tied to another and you're torn between two lovers, feeling like a fool. Like, I can't sleep, I can't eat, I can't drink. I need a soul extreme makeover. I can't help myself. I'm desperate. So the word is a cleansing agent. It's just like, you don't wash your clothes without powder or something. And I don't wash my clothes, I ain't gonna use no powder because, you know, you take your clothes out, they're gonna be stained. They sure are. And they're gonna still be dirty. This is very important that we get it. Glory to God. You got to have a cleansing agent. Our souls need purging by the word. So I mean, my soul needs purging by the word.
It needs purging by the word.
So our lifestyle cannot be pleasing and acceptable unto God unless we not copy the behaviors and customs of the world. But we gotta let God. I will remind you what the scripture says as we go along. Let God change you by changing the way you think. Though the word can only change us, we're only affirmed in the word. And so your self and human reasoning that you can come up with ain't enough. You need a cleansing agent. The man can never supply himself with what's necessary to cleanse. You can't come up with your own soul. You need to go to the store and buy some. And you also need to go get some toothpaste to brush your teeth. I'm just going to brush my teeth with water. I ain't buying no more toothpaste. Well, the toothpaste was made to cleanse. And the scrub, get the plaque off. You got to work. What I'm trying to get you to understand that there's a work. The Bible said, work out your own soul salvation. I'm working on me. I'm getting this word in my head so I can get it right. So I can be that living sacrifice that is holy and acceptable unto men, to God and God alone. Remember 1 Corinthians 6:17 says, but the person who is joined to the Lord's Spirit is one with Him. It is only through those who choose to be joined to the Lord are enabled to have their souls transformed by the word. People try to play with it, and some people are comfortable with their activities as far as their church activities. You know, I can go to church and I can be on the usher board and I can sing, you know, and that's all I'm going to do. You know, if you think your church attendance affirm your salvation, you have gotten it very wrong. It is a transformed lifestyle that has changed from going west, which was a wrong way, to east. This is the right way. I know in this way some things seem to be challenging, but I can do this. Why? Because I'm not going in my own strength anymore. I'm not going in my parents' DNA anymore. It's the blood of Jesus that enables me, enables your lifestyle to be changed by the power of the Holy Ghost, that is enabled by the spoken word. Romans 12, 2. It says, don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Then you will know God's will for you. Then you'll know. That's the only way you'll know, which is good, pleasing, and perfect. So how do we give ourselves to God so that we can honor Him in our bodies that belong to Him? The fact that this passage tells us what not to do indicates that we will be doing it. Or we are doing it. Amen. On our own. Sometimes you do things by default. You don't even understand what you're doing. But when the truth comes, when life comes, when something is confronting you with what's right, you say, oh, I didn't know I was doing that. Our human nature is built not to consider or reflect upon what we're really doing.
Come on,
settle. Many times our words are just killing folks softly. We think. But we're killing them hard. You call people names, fat ugly, get your black son. Get your old lazy self. You're just stupid. So this type of living that we are used to living has to be understood, that we're not used to living, has to be understood. And it must be erased. You're not born with knowing what to do unless your spirit feels. Maybe I give people too much credit. They that are led by the Spirit are the sons of God. And the Spirit will tell you what to do. He will lead you. Glory to God. learn to transform your soul by what? Hearing God, getting in a relationship with Him. You got a new friend, you learn their voices. If a child can learn the mother's voice and the father's voice in the womb, somebody ain't never seen, surely you can learn God's voice. Amen. If you take a moment. Amen. To get into relationship with Him. He said, my sheep know my voice and they hear me. So we got to train our soul to hear God. We got to learn how to hear from God before reacting upon the usual. You know we know what to do. I ain't got to ask God nothing. I just do it. And then you bump your toe again and say, dang, missed it again. So God allowed you to do that, and hopefully you'll get it after a while. I need to get it to God. I need to hear His voice. I need to allow Him to lead me. And allow Him to tell me what to do in some of these important things that I'm deciding that I'm making. That's what you belong to Him. Not only you're going to have to hear God's voice and know His voice to be successful in this life, but you're going to have to hear Him, be connected to Him, and make it a glory. You can't ignore God down here, thank you, going to heaven. God will say, would you? Well, I don't know you. I couldn't get you to do nothing outside of my house. I couldn't get you to love. I can't get you to say I'm sorry. I couldn't get you to pray. So we got to learn to hear Him. This soul is very fickle, inconsistent. In the day and out tomorrow, because it was born that way. Its inability to make the right choices. Say, my soul is not empowered to make the right choices.
My soul is not empowered to make the right choices.
Without the Spirit of God, you'll be in the day. You'll say, well, I thought I wanted that, but now I don't want it. I thought I wanted that. That's why people marry one person, then they go over there and they play with that person. And I married him, but I don't know if I do that. Somebody like that. I need to go to the store with them. As a matter of fact, I made my business not there. And I'm like, can you really make up your mind what you want to do? God, name. I'll be all between two opinions. Just know what you want and go for what you want. Yeah. So this soul can be fickled. Like a, you know, like a spontaneous effect. Oh, I know what I want to do. That's why you can't be led by your sinful nature. Because you'll find yourself on the wrong track. Moving in impulses. Some people get up just like that. Move by impulse at the drop of a hat. I think I'm going over there and buy this car. I think I'm going over there and buy this house. I think I'm going over there and do this. It's like, oh, I thought we were doing this. Well, you know, double-minded man receive nothing. Stability, stableness. When you look for people to connect with, make sure they're stable. Don't connect with people that's unstable. Don't do it. Especially when they change on you. It's like you don't switch three times. Is this a signal? I don't know. I don't want to get no more. I don't know if I want you to be my friend no more. I don't know if I'm going to business with you. We have to learn to practice righteous living. Truth told. We will not be enabled. The enablement of our souls has not happened as a result of self-righteousness. But it is only through the power of God. Jesus said, take my yoke. Learn. Practice me. For my way is easy and my burden is light. So if you hate to learn, you're not going to get this. So the Word of God is not a recorded book of rules and regulations. We do not read the Word like a novel and say, I read the Word today. What did the Word tell you to do?
Amen.
Say it with me, when I read the Word,
I'm learning
what I need to be doing.
I need to
read it. The word has already been established. Everything that belongs to Christ and pertaining to righteousness has already been established. You don't have to be cooking up nothing. You don't have to let self-reasoning and go and see if I can fix the word. I'm going to try to fix Jesus. See if I can fix God. Some people just let grace. You know, this looks broken. You know, I need to take the word of God just like it is and believe it. Even when it blows my little wig off, when it says Mary had a baby without a man, I just, I don't try to scientifically fill it out. Well, how God spoke the ocean? Well, I said they tell me in their words. Let me see if I can go fit that out. No, it is what it is. That's where faith comes in. That's why you must be saved by faith, meaning I trust God. I believe what he did. If God said it, I believe it, and that settles it. That means I'm not going to allow human reasoning itself to try to co-mingle with truth and error. Some people, that's why they're crazy. So we learn to practice the word. The need is so great to know what the word is saying, to I don't think we really understand how desperate we are. We really don't. The church is in a desperate need, and her posture needs to show that. Pride has taken us so far. Till I know it's going to be the word that brings us back. It's going to be prayer. It's going to be confronting and telling the truth and dealing with self and telling the truth on yourself. Because I really don't think we really understand how far the church has went outside of where we should be concerning this word. Thank God for his grace. Thank God for his mercy that he has released upon us, that calls us to partake even in our frail, human frailties, and our misuse or misunderstanding. Grace and mercy is still calling for us. It's still wooing us. It's still calling us into God's presence. Mercy still opened the way for us to come to God. Grace, which is Christ, expense at God's righteousness, waiting and calling us. Calling us and beckoning us into the glory. When we get into the glory of God, that's when illumination comes. The glory is in his word. The enlightenment, the understanding, it is in the word of God. That's why you need to be in it. Take your eye, get out of Facebook. Get out of his book. Get out of iSpace, MySpace. And get in the book. Because what your eyes are gazing upon is what you will become. If you want to know the truth, you're going to have to get into the word of God. In the glory. The Bible says, no man come to the Father except he draws them. It is the glory of God that draws. This is where grace and mercy is still made open to the church. And those that peradventure will come to God. Thank God. You might not understand now. And you might be sort of lost in your head. But the mercy of God is still calling you into the glory so your insight can be open and you can really see. Oh, I see. I don't have to be so caught up on that. Well, I feel like I need that more than anything. I can't turn my back on that and really be at peace between me and God. I can really be free of this addiction. I really can be. I don't have to be addicted to this thing any longer. I can let unforgiveness go because I understand that Christ already forgiven me. I can see that I got some issue too. So the glory allows things to be seen as to what they really are. And so the word say for us not to copy the behavior and customs of this world. When we know and understand what this word is saying, we can really submit under the power of God that he may exalt us. That's why the Bible says, submit yourself therefore unto God. Resist the devil. He's telling you to submit so you can stop copying him. Submit yourself unto God so I can lift you up. You can be enabled to stop going after the behaviors of the world and your sinful nature. But I need you to submit. I mean, my grace is right there. You can't come unless I draw you. My grace is drawing you. My mercy is drawing you. Will you accept the invitation? Well, many times we get so busy because we don't understand that God is calling us into holy living. He's calling us to participate in the good and perfect and pleasing lifestyle. But will we accept the invitation? Glory to God. The power of God is brought to full fruition where we can understand. The word copy means to duplicate. You can find yourself duplicating and replicating to other people, and it ain't even gone. People make excuses for sin because they see other leaders do it. Or other people that seem to be getting away. Well, they do it, they can do it too. Oh, why not? A man like that is living in a dangerous thing. If you allow this here to allow you to look around and to model your life in Christ by what you see, you're going to miss it. Because the people we think that are given are not. I see it from the pulpit. I'm like, serious? And you got a group of people following you for real? I see this in people that I fellowship with, people I like. People I cool with. You got to be in a relationship with God. And when God tell you, don't do that. Back up on that. I don't care who. I don't care how comfortable you feel with that. I don't care who did it, what did it, where did it. I'm telling you. This one relationship with God calls you not to copy other folk. You duplicate. Duplicate. It means to imitate. Reproduce. To not copy is a hard thing for the human nature. This ain't about your emotions and what you want to do. But this is what I feel like I need to do. If your feelings is in it, you're going to miss it. You know what? As high as the heaven is from the earth, is God's ways from our feelings. So you can't go by what feels right. It's what is right. Look at it. Is it right for me? Is it right for me? Is that, think about it. Am I influencing somebody else the wrong way? What am I doing? It's a hard thing for not to copy. You know what? Because we've been created from the dirt, the dust. Go with me to Psalms 51. We've been created from the dust of the ground and born in sin, the word says. So it's easy for us to copy what we see. Because what we see is already in us. We just ain't learned how to reject our own self. You never been letting that thing get away. That's what you've been doing. You've been letting it get away. You can't be comfortable with sin, living a habitual, secret, sinful lifestyle just that nobody else don't see it. You think it's all right with God. But no, it's not. He won't hold it and acceptable to you. That's pleasing to him. And what he got for you is his good and perfect will. I would rather want what God wants than what I can cook up for myself. Because the truth be told, what we cook up for ourselves and what we really see, it ain't really all that. There's nothing good about it. That's why people commit suicide. People isolate themselves from other people. Yeah. And they live in unforgiveness and a strong spirit of bitterness because they become one with that thing. Their body resembles it. When they walk, you can see it on them. It's easy to copy because it's in us, but thank God we are able to make the transformation. First verse. Transformation comes when we really allow this word to help us to see our true self, where we can submit to what is right. This is David. Have mercy on me. And Crystal was talking about mercy during praise and worship this morning. She was writing. This is David talking about him all himself. Not his brother, not his sister, not his mother, not his daddy, but talking about himself. Amen. David says, have mercy on me, O God, because of your unfailing love, because of your great compassion. Blot out the stain of my sins. Wash me clean from my guilt. Purify me from my sin, for I recognize my rebellion. It haunts me day and night. Against you and you alone have I sinned. I have done what is evil in your sight. You will be proved right in what you say, and your judgment against me is just. You are telling the truth about me, Lord. That is me. So I was born a sinner. Yes, from the moment my mother conceived me. And so we accept Christ and just expect these ways to just stay in the wind. It's a dangerous thing for a man to receive Christ and get saved and think that he's supposed to live the same.